What's up, everybody? Pal 702 back today with another high-end mechanical squonk review. We got the Moddog Stige. I believe it's Stige. On the front right here, it does say Delta Projects, but that's just some like subdivision of Moddog. This is a Moddog product. Anyways, the Stige 3D printed 18650 only mechanical squonker. Definitely something that it's a very different squonker. Very cool. So what we're gonna do right about now is we're gonna go downtown. I'm gonna show you all around this Moddog Stige. We're gonna pop building it, listen to some Tool. They got a new album coming out. Pop back up, pros and cons. You know we do it. All right, and today it is the Moddog Stige mechanical 3D printed squonker Delta Projects. So Delta Projects, I really don't know what the deal is with Moddog, but it's on the same side as Moddog. So it's just, I don't really know, but it's Moddog because look, looks like Moddog to me. There'll be nothing else on this box. All right, so once you tear into this Moddog box, by the way, Moddog is a fine Italian modder, you will have your squonker in this pouch, which we'll go over in a second. So for your extras now, there'll be an extra O-ring, which will go around like your 510, and then there's a metal, this little metal guy right here, and it's actually a stem that goes in the bottom of your squonk tube. So if you want, you insert this into the bottom of your tube instead of cutting it, because it has, well, let me just show you. See, it has all these little hash marks in it, so when this is pressed directly down at the bottom of your bottle, it can still suck juice in, so pretty cool. I never put it in just because I'm lazy, but I'm sure it works pretty good. All right, right there, you're checking out the Moddog Goldilocks silicone smoked 7 milliliter squonk bottle that it comes with. And it is very juicy because, well, I was vaping this thing today. And when you unscrew your bottle, you will see that the filling port is tiny. So if you're dripping with like glass bottle dripper, it's gonna be a pain in the ass to get that in there. Unicorn bottle works fine. Chubby Gorilla, you can kind of slam in there, but definitely this is not a generous filling port on this squonk bottle. Overall though, nice bottle. And here is the Moddog Stige. So the Moddog Stige, you can get this thing either fully assembled or you can get it completely in parts and put it together yourself. Very similar to the Pulsar that we did a while back, which I will leave a link at the end of this review on. All of this will be 3D printed. It is all PA12. And you can see it's just got crazy curves, crazy ergonomics on it. This is one of those designs that you're either going to absolutely love or you're gonna hate it just because of all of the aggressive lines on this. I think it's pretty badass. So up top now, you are going to have Moddog's new 510 system, which is the Nano V2. And this 510 is awesome. It's a solid 510 pin. Reverse threaded, you adjust it right there from the top. Super simple. This mod hits very, very, very hard. Now this top piece right here, this is just a two-piece operation. So you just pull, top piece comes off. So that's a better look at your Nano V2 510. So underneath the 510 now, you'll see everything is 0.999 silver, and just something that's kind of different on this, besides the fact that this whole top pops off, is what they did with the 3D printing. Now the switch itself it presses against these guys right here. And these are 3D printed, and these just bend back. And once these bend back far enough, your, right here, your strike plate will make contact with your actual contact inside your mod. And the cool thing about this is if you loosen this nut right here, you can push this forward. You can see I've pushed mine forward to make the throw shorter. But if you loosen this, you can push this back even further. So you can adjust your throw on this super easy. There's a lot of adjustment on it. Very, very nice. You could also see there's one magnet here. And then on the actual mod itself, the other magnet is on that. So one magnet stays in here, one magnet stays on the other one, and that helps keep everything attached. Okay, so you can see right there, there's the magnet that's left in, and then there's the other magnet right there. So just to put this thing together, just like that. And once you have your squonk bottle on and everything like that, this thing never pops off. Between the magnets and the actual weight of the squonk bottle, this doesn't come off. Your switch is gonna be right here. And like I showed you, you can totally adjust this. It's just a little tiny square cutout, totally flush with the mod itself. And you can see as you push it, you can see that 0.999 silver contact moving in, and that is what reaches that guy right there. Very simple, but very cool how they use 3D printing right there to make resistance. And that's just a shot just right down the mod because there are no doors, so you can see the actual contacts. Now these pop out. I mean, you just grab this thing and it pops right out. No big deal, but you can see it's all one piece. It's one just L.999 silver contact right there. So very basic, simple mod. One more thing I will, I don't want to forget. Underneath this, which would be, they call it your positive contact, so I guess you're going to run positive up on this. At least in the manual, they say this is your positive contact. There's a spring underneath here. So this spring literally takes out all the battery rattle. So you don't have to worry about any battery rattle. It's 18650 only. And let's just throw it together real quick so we can see. So, squonk bottle, right on like this. And then you would take your Samsung 20S 18650, fully charged, beautiful blue cell. Drop it in like so. And then this guy like this. Voila, just like that. And she is ready to rock and roll. Never had the top fly off at all. And if it was gonna fly off, it'd fly off, right? I mean, I don't have any liquid in there, so I can't shake it like super hard. But I mean, it won't fall off. Now, as far as atomizers that go on top of here, the biggest you're gonna get is a 24. So this is the Goon 1.5. So this isn't the 25 millimeter. But I mean, that's a 24 right there. And that's as much as you're gonna get right there. This front piece right here will not allow you to do a 25. And another thing you want to be careful of is this does come up. So if you have lower set airflow, you're going to want to make sure and adjust your 510 to where your airflow is coming off from the side, not going directly like that. And then here's the Flav 22. 22 is the way to roll with this. 22 single coil, 18650. So there she is next to her big brother, the Pulsar, also by Moddog. It is definitely smaller in the hand, just the way that it feels. This is a much larger box. It looks like they're about the same height, but the way that this is ergonomically designed, it feels like half the mod. And it's super crazy light because it's 3D printed. And that is it against the Luxotic, which I'm just trying to compare it to 18650. Basically mechanical. I mean, the Luxotic's unregulated, but it doesn't really have an actual screen or anything. But as you could tell, very, very small, very compact in the hand. And that's it. That's all there is to the Moddog Stige. So what are we gonna put on it today? We're gonna put this Haku Phenom deck on there. And we will be using some, I got some new coils. super cool dude, Matt Clark, sent me some coils that he made. These are NI80 Aliens, 26 gauge, 3 cores, and it's a 3mm, 6 wrap, 0.25 if you're doing a single, is what it says. Kind of nice, actually, on his packaging. He writes everything out. So, pretty awesome. And thank you for sending those, Matt, and the letter, too. That was very, very, very nice of you, man. I appreciate it, brother. It's time to build this bad boy, so hit it. A little bit of Tool. Prison sex? It's the only kind of sex, right? But more importantly, that was the Moddog Stige, which is an Italian 3D printed PA12 0.999 silver contact Nano V2 510 7mm silicone smoked SQUONK bottle powered by a Samsung 20S with a Matt Clark alien. Let's take it for a rip. All right, so what we're gonna do right about now, we're gonna do pros and cons. We're gonna start off with the cons, end on the pros, because around here, we always end on a positive note. Cons on the Moddog Stige, there will be none. There will be none. There's none. I thoroughly enjoy everything about this mod right here, including the price, so stay tuned for that. We're just gonna go right to pros. First pro, tiny, small, light, 18650 Mech Squonker. You guys know that's my thing, I love it. I mean, it's frigging, I mean, this thing is tiny. Next pro, ergonomics. The way that this thing fits in your hand, your thumb goes just like this. I mean, you can go both ways, so left, right. You can do the ambidextrous thing. Ambidextrous, doesn't matter. Very nice though, in the hand, feels very, very, very good. Next pro has gotta be the Nano V2 510. It's probably the SVF Reset and the Nano V2 are in a tie for my favorite 510 systems ever. This 510 system is very, very nice. And they sell them separate too, so if you just wanna buy that 510 system and put it in another Squonker, you can do that too. Another pro on the Squonk windows, they're from either side. I mean, it's bigger on this side. So I mean, it's really more made for a right-handed Squonker, but I mean, left hand is fine. But if you look, like, this window is a little bit smaller than that window, but they're both super easy to reach. And for the, you know, the rest of the pros, they're gonna be very similar to other high-end mechanical Squonkers, you know, with the 0.999 silver contacts on there, you know, PA12, 3D printed. It's, I don't know, man. I don't even like 3D printed mods either. That's the thing. I don't, like, I feel like they feel cheap and they suck. I'm sorry, maybe the Rebel did that to me. But I love this mod. Like, I think because it just feels so good in the hand. It just feels so good in the hand, and it's just crazy light. And like I said, it hits super hard. All right, so price. What will the Moddog Stige cost you? Cost this guy $390. You wanna know why? Cause my mom is so cool, she bought me this for Christmas. What? Shout out to my mom. Thanks, mom, good looking out. Seriously, my mom bought it for me for Christmas. But if you guys are interested in picking one up, I'm gonna drop the link right here. This is Moddog's link. You don't have to fuck around with Facebook groups or lists or anything like that. If you want it, you can go over there right now and buy it. It's like 115 euros. I think it was like 150 bucks. $150 for an Italian 3D printed badass mechanical squonk mod in that kind of realm. In the world of especially like anything coming from Italy, 150 bucks. Yeah, it's a win. So that is it. That is all that I have for you today on the Moddog Stige. Massive shout out to all you guys for tuning in, and I do not know what's going on your world today, but I do know that it's Friday, which is payday, which is definitely my favorite day. So around here, with a 3D printed mod that I actually just really love, this and like the Oni Maru are like, that's it. Hook Rebel. It is definitely ALLOVE. And I'll catch you guys on Monday. Haku.